Right. Design inspiration 2021.
Elon Musk got inspired by astronauts like Neil Armstrong to create SpaceX, so much so that he cried in an interview when they asked him why Neil Armstrong and other astronauts do not support SpaceX. And if your favorite crypto god can be inspired by someone else to create something of his own, well, so can you. And that is what today's video is all about. I'm going to divide today's video into two very crucial parts. One will be where I show you tools and resources to get great UI inspiration and other inspiration as well. And the second part will be me talking about what I believe design inspiration should be all about, how you should get inspired by a certain creation, product, design, whatever it might be, and why people look down upon design inspiration in the commercial world. Timestamps, like always, will be given in the description. In case you want to skip to a position, you can always do that. Without further ado, let's just get started. So the first website we're going to look at is designvault.io. Now this is a very unique one. It allows you to pick a variety of applications, and I love how it's categorized each application into different sections. I also love how they've used these little emojis to kind of depict each one of them. Get into their applications. Check out each and every screen here. You can even choose between the web app and the iPhone app. So you get to see the website as well as the application. That's very cool. Even filter different sections. So if you want to see, say, a home page, it'll show you the home page for web app and iOS. If you want to see something like the list, so it'll show you how it displays, how the application displays a list, and it's very, very unique. The website also has a pattern section, which allows you to select out of each and every pattern here. So for example, you are looking at a loading screen. You want inspiration for a loading screen. You can check out loading screens from various applications. Then you have my personal favorite, which is Duolingo. As you can see, this little parrot dances around. Cool thing is that the developer is constantly adding new apps and websites to this platform, so you can keep on checking their new platforms. The best part is the filter section, of course. It shows you each and every component into a filtered list, and that is what really attracted me to this. More so ever, you can even sign up to their email list. So whenever they add a new app, they'll let you know in your email, and I think that is very useful. Now, we often get stuck at finding good ideas for a next product or a next design. This ideasgrab.com allows you to find and generate new ideas for your next project or your next UI design. This list, as you can see, is updated daily. So you have 3,000 ideas already there, but new ideas will be added daily. And a cool functionality is that if you highlight anything on the screen, you can either copy it or share it in your network. So you can, you know, share ideas through this. Now let's check out the idea generator, what we're really here for. Each idea is unique. So you can quickly generate a random idea. So a smart fridge that turns down the light when you open it at 2 a.m. Wow, that is quite interesting. If I generate another random idea, it will generate a website idea, a website where you can check alcohol prices at restaurants. This is really cool and actually quite useful if we look at it. So if you're starting a new business or if you just want ideas for your personal projects, this Ideas Grab website can be super useful. If you want to see how this person actually finds ideas, visualizes them, the person has also given this as well. So how to come up with great ideas, you know, the kind of tips that you need to follow. Other creative resources that the author follows, the people that he or she follows, the kind of videos that they have watched to kind of, you know, figure out how to get the best ideas possible. All in all, great resource. And the best part is it has dark mode and both light mode as well. So I found a really old school application. However, this is very interesting. Little Big Details collects all the small details that you find on a website, like this little detail. In Google Sheets or Google Docs, you have this capitalization option. It shows you uppercase in uppercase. Even though it might be a small detail, but these small details can make a huge difference in the long run. So it has covered from various sites and applications, Google Apps, Google Calendar, Slack, Stack Overflow, and so much more. And it just kind of points out the little details that the website or the designer has taken care of. As you can see, if I want to see how YouTube, you know, adds a little bit of detail to their pages, you can see the little details. Of course, animated details like this little play and pause button can give you daily inspiration to kind of solve problems in tiny ways possible. Did you know Apple has their own section called videos where you can get inspired from, whether it be from a tech perspective, you know, AR, VR, development, hardware. Apart from that, they also have a topic section, and this is where it gets interesting. There's an entire section for design. Yes, if you want to check out prototyping, they will have videos and articles and much more on prototyping and how they do it in their own products. The qualities of great design, great developer habits, designing fluid interfaces, and so much more. And each of these is actually a video that has been taken from one of their conferences that they've done. So all their resources into one. Apart from that, you can even download these videos and, you know, create your own section. Apart from that, you can download the PDF slides that they used in their actual conference, documentation and notes. I feel this is a great way for Apple to kind of reach out to the community, to give back in the form of informative videos and stuff like that. Go check this out. It's very interesting. Now, the infamous Pablo Stanley has created a website called Pablo Planeta. And this is more for fun than design inspiration, but I love how this website has been designed. And you can take inspiration from this website design as well. He kind of goes through your horoscope for each and every one right here, Aries, Taurus. Best part is he keeps on updating these sections right here, so you can always subscribe to him here on this website and you can get updates like this very often in your email. The best part is it's made with Webflow, so you can learn how to make this very easily. I'll have a link to a Webflow blog which explains how to make such animations and stuff like that in the description, so you can always check this out as well. Now, we often find websites and landing pages from different kind of purposes. You can check out this website called SaaS Landing Page. My favorite out of these is this Contra website, which I've used for myself as well. It shows you in full, just like you can see on Behance. The neat part about this is that you can see the colors used here, the fonts used here, which is interesting. Also, you can see the kind of code that is used here, the kind of languages that they've used or frameworks that you've used. Next.js and React to create this website right here. And that's a great way to understand what goes behind a product, not just the design. As you can see, it even shows the kind of platforms it's created on. So this is a WordPress website. So they've added a WordPress tag here. If you want to check out other designs made using WordPress, you can always click on this WordPress link here. And all these landing pages have been made in WordPress. And how impressive and cool are these? It even shows you plugins and stuff like, oh man, I'm done. This is amazing. I think this should be your one-stop shop to check out different websites and landing pages. It's called SaaS Landing Page. Go check it out. I am endorsing it. As a cherry on the top, it has dark mode as well. So, well, now my day is made. It's complete. I'm done. Just kidding. We have more resources to go through. Obscure mobile design techniques to boost your UX. This is a great article. I'm notorious for showcasing amazing articles on the channel. This one on Smashing Magazine hits the nail. Kind of shows you different examples, the problems that they've identified and the solutions that they've come up with. So each little solution has been given a visual representation, how the problem statement was taken up and how the solution was come up with. This is a great way to understand how case studies work and how an effective case study can be made as well. Apart from that, Smashing Magazine is like an OG when it comes to great content in a reading form like this. Now, I've mentioned this app before, but I think they have updated it since I last saw it. It is a very neat and clean design to kind of showcase UX principles, ideas, problems, as well as solutions to each and every aspect of design, as you can see. So if you want to learn design while getting inspired on how to do something or how to find a solution to something, this is a great application to have on your mobile. To my knowledge, this also has an iOS counterpart. So if you're looking for an iOS app or an Android app to kind of have on your phone, UX Toast is a great example to start off with. So those were some really cool new tools, except one. Now let's look at why people hate the word design inspiration. Now let's face it, we all started from somewhere. And even when I was starting off, I was looking at what other designers were making, the solutions that they were coming up with, the kind of style that they had, or the kind of trend that was going on. And everything that people consider as a cliche in design, I did myself as well. But there's a small group of people in the design world that believe that looking at Behance or Dribbble designs is a sin. And to be honest, I don't completely disagree with them also. Design comes from finding a solution to a problem on your own through research data, validation, analysis, testing, and so many different techniques. But at the end of the day, we must realize that all that comes from learning from somewhere else. We all do that, don't we? In college, we learn from a professor. In school, we learn from a teacher. At jobs, we learn from our seniors or our leaders. So we must look at other products or other designs as an inspiration. If we feel that another product is doing something right, we can always add a little twist to it, but we can always borrow that idea from there, add a little twist, tweak it according to our users or the people looking at our designs and make it our own. At the end of the day, I believe inspiration is a great thing, but it's shown in a very bad light. It's like design trends. Since the word design trend is so overused and people tend to copy design trends blindly, what is your source of design inspiration is another very crucial aspect of inspiration in general. Behance and Dribbble are great for visual design and UI design representations. I also find a lot of animations there, a lot of 3D there that we can take a lot of good points from. However, everything on Behance is presented in such a way that it tends to look prettier and less functional. So I say, go check out tools, go check out different websites, go check out actual monuments, museums, art galleries, and so much more in and around your city. I hope you like this video. I come up with such amazing content every Monday and Thursday. You guys support me a lot. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure that you press the little bell icon right next to the subscribe button. And if you like the video, thumbs up. It's free. I'll see you guys next time and with another amazing video. Till then, God bless.